Hey, it's Dan Zimmerman. Welcome to Illustrate to Educate. Don't forget to subscribe for simple, objective videos on topics that matter.
Welcome back to Explain Through Rap, the channel you love that explains cool facts. If you like our stuff and need to rhymes, like, comment, share, and please subscribe. SpaceX is a company that found my eye with its reliable rocket, the Falcon 9. It safely did trips to the ISS. Pretty damn impressive, though, I profess. NASA has authorized the Falcon 9 to transport their astronauts around sometimes. It was the first rocket so outlandish to nail the art of propulsive landing. But it's not big, so it can't go that far, kids. To reach far away places and go to Mars, it's going to need something to cope with large trips, something the size of the new SpaceX Starship. Musk is a big rocket to see the stars in, with missions lined up that are so bizarre. It could even save the human race from darkness. But what is it? Let's get to know the Starship. The vessel called the Starship had two other names, bro. The big Falcon rocket was a rubbish name, though. The interplanetary transport system was slightly better, but Starship is now its title, whether or not you like it, Greta. That's the chosen name. The heavy lift rocket can take large payloads to space, but it's a two-stage vehicle, or so it says, because the Starship isn't the only stage. It's a key part with crew and cargo inside, but it's stacked on a first stage, so it's nice. The first stage is called the Super Heavy, which is a necessary part to do propelling of the spacecraft outside Earth's gravity, as its pull on the Earth is massive, see? And it can reach its destination, then it's got much less gravity it must contend with. So can launch itself without the Super Heavy, and we can all relax and drink a few cool bevies. Starship is fully reusable, it's slick and robust. I'm unsure if they can reuse Super Heavy though, bruv. SpaceX is good at landing Falcon 9 boosters, but the rocket's so comparatively enormous it's stupid. Musk said they plan to try catching Super Heavy with a launch tower, but it doesn't sound super ready. Oh, very easy. Starship is 50 meters tall. The diameter is 9 meters, sure. Which makes Starship a lot roomier than the Falcon 9. It's groovier. It was 3.6 meters in diameter, dude, so the Starship by comparison is massively huge. It has 6 3D printed Raptor engines to bust, giving it 5,550 kN width to thrust. 3 of the engines are designed for sea level use, and in a vacuum are where the other 3 get their use. They use a sub-cooled liquid methane and liquid oxygen propellant, man. Super Heavy has 33 Raptor engines, all sea level variants I have to mention. Given the stacked rocket a total lift-off thrust of 74,000 kN, it's big, hard stuff. NASA's space launch system is expected to have 39,000 kN of thrust it's blessed with. What will Starship be used for, though? I'll tell you what it will be used for, bro. The benefit of a bigger rocket is plain, yo. Greater range and heavier payload. Starship could get to 50 tons to low Earth orbit. In an expendable config that they worked for it. Or 150 tons with some vehicle recovery. With orbital refueling, which will be lovely. It'll extend the range, which is hella great. Musk has been talking about Mars, but there's many ways it can be used. It'll likely focus first on operations in the orbit of the Earth. It's first maybe the dearMoon mission, it's fair. Paid for by Maezawa, the billionaire. SpaceX will send Maezawa into space. Not alone, no, he will have picked some mates. Musk will use Starship probably to have a try. Deploying Starlink internet satellites. Falcon 9 takes 60 small ones at a time into orbit, but they want a massive line of 12,000 satellites in circulation, or maybe many more depending on regulations. Starship's large capacity will make that snappy. The astronomers probably won't be happy. After the kinks are worked out, it's great. It'll only cost 2 mil to launch it into space. That makes the constellation deployment cheaper than their competitors to Musk's enjoyment. It'll also take large commercial payloads into space, and they won't need to payloads. Much cheaper than our reusable rockets, much less of a dent in SpaceX's pockets. NASA is interested in Starship too. They've tapped SpaceX to help with Artemis Moon landing by providing their human landing system. It's unclear the time timeline for this mission. Starship could also work like a plane and get you anywhere in the world. It's quite insane, but it'd be the most uncomfortable ride by far, and people are more interested by a ride to Mars. Musk envisions 100 starships in flight, with 100 people on each starship, right? The earliest flight to Mars is 2024, but there'd be no crew, and there's plenty more other uses that might take precedence. Colonizing Mars might not be relevant for a long time, but it might well be best, as we don't know the long-term health effects. Exploring planets has never seemed so possible. The Starship will help us to see impossible. If you have a request, please comment that with a topic you want. I'll drop a rap. I'm no physics expert, I'm just nice with the rhymes. It helps the channel if you hit like and subscribe.